Donut time.
It seems it's always donut time in Los Angeles, which boasts the most donut shops in the country. And a new documentary shows how that came to be. It started with this man.
They call me Donut King.
Ted Ngoy came to California in 1975 as a refugee from Cambodia, when the Khmer Rouge imposed a brutal communist regime on the country. Within 3 years, he had become a millionaire, creating his own chain of donut shops across the city. The Donut King director, Alice Gu, says as an LA native, she was fascinated by his story.
It was a different take on a refugee story. This was a success story of what can happen when just given an opportunity to thrive in an adopted homeland. And I like that it put a human face on what a refugee is for most people.
The way the king was able to expand his empire so fast was by hiring other Cambodian refugees to work for him.
Uncle Ted brought us here to survive.
He says he sponsored more than 100 Cambodian families to come to Los Angeles, where he provided them housing and jobs in his shops. The model worked so well that for a long time, chains like Dunkin' Donuts were unsuccessful in attempts to create their own market in LA.
So there's a David and Goliath component to this film, that this little unlikely crew of independent donut shops who are not fancy, they're in strip malls, they do not have commercials, they're not particularly branded, but they have really close ties with the community. And after years of being in the community, they've gained loyal followings.
At the height of his success, Ted estimated his wealth to be around $20 million. The money came quickly, but it seemed to go just as fast.
I lost everything, believe me, everything.
Ted admits he developed a gambling addiction, and repeated visits to Las Vegas chipped away at his success. To pay his debts, he started to sell off his donut shops one by one, until there was nothing left.
He had a pretty spectacular fall, and he lost everything that was more important than money. You know, the respect of his community, the respect and the love of his family and the love of his life. And I think that you, hopefully, you know, you learn some lessons after, you know, suffering those kinds of setbacks.
After losing everything, Ted left the U.S. and went back to Cambodia. The families he sponsored continued running their businesses. Today, more than 90% of independent donut shops in Los Angeles are owned by Cambodian families. The film also documents his revisit to the U.S. to see what was left of his legacy, which includes the many families he helped in creating their own American dream.
It's incredible to think that one man had so much impact that affected hundreds and thousands of people.
Wow, what a memory.
To see where you can watch the documentary, visit DonutKingMovie.com. For Inside Edition Digital, I'm Mara Montalbano.